Hello, everybody. We are playing nothing. Frey is going to be playing.
I am playing.
Yes, Frey will be playing Juggernaut. Because Frey, I'm going to teach Frey how to carry.
Good morning, dudes. How is it going?
Shut up, Frey. Shut up. I hate you. And people have been asking for coaching on YouTube. And I thought this was really the best way to do it. So that's what we're going to do here. It's pretty simple. We're gonna start with Juggernaut, then we're probably gonna I want to cover the three big carries first. So in the current meta game, there are three heroes that define how you play a carry and are really the strongest ones there are. That's Juggernaut, Troll Warlord, and Sniper. And I feel like if we start with those, then we get a very basic and not really just the basic, but a pretty good understanding of the meta game, and then we can go from there. So it's just going to be the usual safe lane Juggernaut farming things, and that's that. Frey, if you have any questions, you ask.
I will.
And that is basically the plan here. And I'm going to be shouting at you and sound very disinterested about everything.
That sounds like a plan.
Yes. Fantastic. Great.
I watched your video.
No, don't.
I didn't watch.
You didn't watch a video. Don't watch a video.
Took a peek at it.
No, you didn't. Shut up.
Snuck a peek.
No, no. So, first of all, you want to, I don't know what you usually start with, but I like the Quelling Blade, Shield, and Tangos. Right.
Okay.
That's just how I like to go about it. I think it's pretty good on Juggernaut, but you know, that's kind of like a thing whether it comes down to whether or not you like it. Going up against nothing too scary, honestly. Like, they have a lot of early game, a lot of stun and shit, but you should be fine because you're Juggernaut. So, you usually want to go at the rune, to the rune. Because Juggernaut has the spin, which at level 1 deals 400 damage.
Okay.
And that is really good. Like, that is a lot of damage for an ability at level 1. So, you can usually get the rune just fine. Because, you know, you just apply a lot of pressure and you're really scary. And there's not really anybody that wants to fight you. Like, they can, but usually they don't want to. So, it should be fine. You should be able to take this, no problem. Keeping the skill point is fine, honestly. But I think right now, just, I don't know, with Juggernaut, I think just slapping the point into the Blade Fury is okay. You know.
Get out of there, Teemo. For sake. Mine.
No, it's not. It's Teemo's.
It's yours.
Yes.
You're pretty.
Why is it Teemo's?
Because Teemo is the mid, and the mid has more troubles getting farmed than you will have on your tri-lane.
I see.
And if he gets an early bottle, that's just beneficial to the team. And it's just, you know, you give the rune to the mid. At least that's what I usually.
No,
advise. Seems like a decent idea. So you got
Sensei Captain.
Sensei. No, but you got a really powerful lane going on. Honestly, this is pretty neat.
Still made it.
Yeah. Now at the same time, this lane is very squishy and can easily die. With last hitting, just take a look at your damage, take a look at the creep's HP, and think about it. Right? People usually last hit just based on instinct, and just fucking try to do the math on it. Just take a look at how much damage you deal, which currently, you have 52, that's another 32% on top of that. So that's another 15, probably. It's actually a little bit more than that.
You actively look at the Hecate's health?
If I'm really trying, which I'm usually not in my videos, but if I'm really trying, yes. Because that's just the best way to do it, right? Or you don't actually need to click on the creeps manually, right? But you just kind of need to see the number. Take a look at it once and then see where the little life bar needs to be for you to be in last hit range. And it's just a nice thing to just stick those numbers into your head. Right? You just have them in there once. And once you have them in there, it's much easier to last it because you actually know how much damage you deal. Which is super useful. So right now, again, you deal about 70. That's kind of what you want to have in mind. And you know, last hitting underneath the tower is always difficult. You want to stay away from that, honestly. Your perfect lane position is around here, right? This. Since it's not easy to gank you with the creep wave is here. It's super difficult, actually. And at the same time, you are able to last it just fine because it's not in tower range.
Okay, I'm going to have to shut this Juggernaut up a bit.
I would just pause the game really quick, honestly. There we go. Okay, I guess that works. Skill build, you get 1 point into everything, and then you get stats. Do you know why you get stats?
To be more powerful, basically.
Yeah, I guess that's
the,
kind of
the
what
E doesn't
on.
Scale too well.
The E does scale pretty well. Like E, you definitely want to max it. But the point is that very early on, right until level 7 or 8, something around that mark, getting stats just makes your hero stronger, right? He's just all around better. So you kind of want to stick to that. Items like Hand of Midas or Battle Fury or any of those like big scary farming items aren't really great on Juggernaut. So I think I would just go ahead, grab myself the face boots, right? Then maybe get lifesteal or something, depending if I need regen. Which you don't, like you're doing perfectly fine, you're farming uncontested. And then work on the Mask of Madness. And those are really your three big core items. Those are what you're looking for right now.
So Ring of Aquila as well.
Ring of Aquila is actually very important. Juggernaut is not the smartest hero in the game. He's got an intelligence gain of 1.4. Kind of stupid, honestly. Kind of a dumb hero. On multiple, like I guess on multiple levels with multiple meanings. But he's just, you know, he's a little... He runs out of mana if you use the Mask of Madness, which we are going to constantly spam, right? The Mask of Madness, as soon as it's off cooldown, you use it. All the time. Always. Right, because it's used for movement, it's used for farming, for everything. For basically all you're going to do, you're going to be using the Mask of Madness. And with the Ring of Aquila, you're always going to have enough mana. If you don't have the Ring of Aquila, you will actually kind of run out of mana eventually. Because even though the Mask of Madness might not be able to do it, you're not going to regen mana. Because you're constantly using the Mask of Madness, which negates your natural mana regen. So if you ever find yourself using an ultimate on something, or you use a healing ward, then all of a sudden that mana's just gone, right? It's just not there anymore because you're going to be using the Mask of Madness. You just don't have any anymore. You just don't have any mana left.
People are distracting me so much.
What people?
Oh, in the chat.
Just don't listen to the chat. That's what I do. Just ignore the chat. Who gives a fuck? But yeah, Ring of Aquila is really nice. It's also a very cost-effective item. It actually gives you a lot of, like, a lot of additional stats. That's... If I got it right in my head, Ring of Aquila gives you 18 damage, which is kind of great, honestly. 18 is really good for an item that is pretty cheap and gives you like great mana regen, a lot of other stats. And another cool thing about the Ring of Aquila is that it gives you pushing potential, right? Like you can activate it and then the creeps are going to be more powerful and allows you to go ahead and start breaking down some towers, which is always a nice benefit to have. I would really get the boots now, honestly. I would even get, like, my first blades of attack. Just because, you know, it helps with last hitting a little bit. I know, every little bit helps.
I'm trying to figure out the healths when looking at them.
Well, in terms of damage right now, you want to skill your healing ward, by the way. Oh, you didn't get the healing ward. You want to have a point into the healing ward. Healing ward is really useful. It's actually a very powerful ability. Unlike the blade fury, which is kind of shit, honestly. but yeah, you definitely want the healing ward. It's not that bad that you didn't skill it, because, you know, the heroes you're going up against are not posing any sort of threat. But you still want to have it, just in case.
I'm gonna figure the illusion ward.
Okay.
Yeah.
Almost got the face boots. Oh!
Actually, just one thing about the Ring of Aquila. I still think you should get it, because it's just really nice, like, for the stats and everything. But it's not required this game, because you do have a crystal maiden.
Crystal.
Yeah. Like, you're actually going to be fine on mana. So that entire argument is void in this specific game. But if you don't have a Crystal Maiden, then that is something to keep in mind. But yeah, go ahead and grab the face boots. Those give you a lot of bonus damage. And they also give you easier access to creeps, which is neat. Like they are usually two things if it comes to farming. This is, like, a big reason why Yules are so powerful in Shadow Fiend. The first thing you need to be able to do if you're farming is you need to be able to kill the creeps quickly. Right, you need to be able to kill them so you get the money from them. Like that, this seems pretty obvious, right? That's, yeah, you know, obviously, right? The second thing is you need to have access to the creeps. And that's where movement comes in, something like a Blink Dagger, like the Mask of Madness, like the Face Boots, like the Saint Jane Yasha, right? Those items really help just getting to the creeps because you're moving quickly and you're going to be mobile and you're going to be all around the map. And that's really like another added benefit of the face boots, right? Like you really just want to go for face boots and Juggernaut pretty much every single time. But right now it's gonna be mostly farming here.
Yeah. Good shell.
Yeah. Like this is just, you know, I'm just gonna relax here. You know, get the Mask of Madness early. That's gonna be fine. And yeah, again, right now you're just farming. There's not much for you to do. You're gonna go ahead and get these few last hits, and you gotta get some core items going, right? Like that's often a thing people seem to forget, but carries actually kind of suck, unless they have at least a few items. Like carries are literally the worst heroes in the game if it comes down to fight like early on.
Without anything.
Yeah, like because they just have no abilities, they have no farm. And like a Crystal Maine is more powerful than a Juggernaut early on. She just is. That early on, however, doesn't last that long. Which is the reason why heroes like Juggernaut and Sniper are so popular and a hero like Crystal Maine is not. Because Crystal Maine fades off quickly, like she stops being useful rather quickly, while heroes like Juggernaut and Sniper come online really soon. Like they are active really quickly, they're gonna be able to start doing things pretty early on in the game. And of course they're super powerful in the late game. But yeah, that's good, right? Keep the creep wave away from the tower. It just makes it easier to last it. Like even if you watch competitive games, you're gonna see a lot of pros miss last hits underneath the tower. It's just difficult. Like it's just so inconsistent sometimes.
Trying to hit my creeps the faster.
Yeah. So you know, grab the lifesteal and just kind of keep this going. You probably want to hotkey the healing ward to a button. Like
I get two or something.
Yeah, I usually have my hero on 1 and the healing ward on 4. Not my hero, not on 1. My hero on 3, but whatever. Oh, you can totally get that kill. Run in. Yup, spin. And easy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Pretty simple. Don't worry about that, man. Just get the kills. This guy's gonna have enough money anyway.
Okay.
But, you know, like, those are just simple kills. You always want to take those. You guys can actually go and stack, like, we're totally uncontested up here. Like, go get some stacks going in the jungle.
We are one.
But yeah, there's nobody up here that's trying to fight you. The Earthshaker went into the jungle now, and you've got plenty of regen with just the Morbid Mask. You gotta be okay. Now, I wouldn't start pushing quite yet. So this is where some mentality split, right? Some people like just, let's go for the tower immediately, right? Best case scenario, we kill it minute zero. I don't like that. I think that keeping a tower alive early on has quite a bit of value. Because it protects you, kind of, right? It keeps the creep wave at a certain area where you're closer to your own tower, which I believe is useful. But, you know. You can definitely spin, yeah. Yeah, that should be another kill. Sweet. And back to farming we go.
Ow.
Well, of course, this is just regular Juggernaut stuff. But this is where, like, a lot of people used to max out the Blade Fury, right? But do you need another point into the Blade Fury? What would it do, right? Like, you deal enough damage. You don't need it. So let's get the other abilities. And, of course, later on, like, as soon as you have that Mask of Madness, you deal more damage through right clicks than you do with Blade Fury. You really do. Like, Blade Fury just doesn't matter in that regard anymore. It's just not that powerful. So, I think you can start pushing this now. Like, I would just attack those creeps so I heal up, you know. You always want to stay at, like, if possible, you want to stay at full HP. Because you're going up against, like, a lot of scary heroes, mostly the Queen of Pain. She can definitely burst you down from full. So, not staying at full is always it's gonna be a little tricky. Okay, yeah, so this is where the Juggernaut rotation comes in, and this is something that is very important. First of all, make sure you get those last hits, right? Even though you're pushing the lane, always make sure you get the last hits. No matter what you're doing, always make sure you get the last hits. Yeah, you go into the jungle, you go ahead and start attacking these creeps, you start killing this creep camp too, and then you go back into the lane. You push the lane again, go back into the jungle. You just, actually right now, you just want to kill this one and then go back over here. But this is the Juggernaut rotation, right? You always keep that going. You go into the jungle, kill a few creeps, go back into the lane, push down the lane, and you apply a lot of pressure that way. It's very similar to how a Shadow Fiend would be played. That Earthshaker, yeah. Don't worry about it. Just get your creeps and continue farming. And yeah, back into the jungle, right? Never let that slow down. Use the face boots actively, use the mask of madness actively. This is what the movement speed is for. Now, it's very unfortunate that there are no cams to farm.
The crystal maiden has been nicking my creep cams.
Yeah, she shouldn't be doing that. She shouldn't be jungling here. This is actually kind of an issue. Like, if your team has a jungler, this doesn't really work that well. But that's okay. But that's okay. So yeah, take care that you get the last hits, right? This is actually something that's a pretty big deal. People seem to forget about last hitting as soon as the laning stage ends. And no, you should still always... those camps don't spawn yet. Now they spawn. But people tend to forget about last hitting as soon as the laning stage ends. And that's just bullshit, right? Like, if you're just gonna go to a creep wave to push it down, make sure you get all of the last hits. I mean, why not? Right? It's just more money. It's free money. Everybody likes free money. You got enough money for the Ring of Aquila now? I would go ahead and pick that up. I still like it, this game. I still think it's going to be useful. Okay. It just gives you some solid stats, you know?
Missing bottom. Arc.
Arc. There it is. Yeah. Okay, so with the Mask of Madness, I guess, like, my description I gave earlier, which was just, like, you use it constantly. I'm probably wrong. Like, of course, you want to time it so that you use it when you're...
Oh, there's an Abaddon here now.
Oh, that's fine. Just go into the lane. You're more powerful than him. Don't worry about it. Even if they go in... Wait, what kind of build is that Abaddon going for? I don't know. Huh. That's a little unfortunate. I would like to know what the Abaddon has. Because that attack slowed a lot. I saw an Orb of Venom. He probably maxed his slow or something stupid like that. Probably shouldn't do that. But yeah. So, you now, as you can see, you farm really quickly, right? This is super efficient, and people like that go for Battle Fury or something wouldn't farm quicker than this, honestly.
I got him missing.
This is about as fast as it's gonna get. Oh, AA. Come on, pop him. Yep. Sweet. Go in. No. You want to save the magic immunity, right? Oh, I guess that works. You need to get out. You need to leave. Just leave. Just leave. Just run back. All the way back. Leave him. All the way back. To the base. You leave this right now. Okay, I guess you can move into the jungle down here. All right, just continue farming. But yeah, that's the problem with the Queen of Pain, right? She just bursts you down so quickly. But this is not really something you need to worry about yet. Oh, that's a big camp. Move back a little more. Like, you want to fight around here. Because then the creeps are stuck at a point where they aren't quite sure whether or not they want to fight you. By the way, if you activate the Mask of Madness, you heal more. Like, you increase your DPS enough. Where the additional damage is negated. So, unless, like, there's a risk of you dying, activating the Mask of Madness is, like, almost never a downside. So, next up, Saint Jinyasha, right? That's gonna make it so that you're really fast. Like, really, like, you're gonna be constantly moving at 522. And,
he stacks, too.
And it makes you really powerful as well, so. But you want to wait until the Yasha's done. Also, I don't know why the courier is just chilling in the base somewhere. I should probably send that back. It's a little odd. Oh well. But yeah, I think you can just go ahead and clear out the jungle now. Like, the top lane seems a little risky. So kill that camp, then move to this one, right? Take that down, and... Yeah, at that point you're gonna be in pretty good position. Like, that's gonna be a done Saint Jinyasha. It's a pretty big camp. And not Saint Jinyasha, but at least Yasha, right? And Yasha is really actually like the important part. The Saint is nice, but the Yasha is really what we're looking for, because like the additional movement speed and agility and everything.
More of a speed.
Yeah. You can also think about killing Roshan now, if you want to do that. Roshan is actually very much possible. Get the Yasha. And now, this is really where it's kind of difficult, right? Like, you need to multitask a lot of things. But that's just kind of how it is, right? You need to constantly have control over the courier. You always need to be get you need to be getting your new items, and you need to keep that cash flow going. I would go to Roshan. Go to Roshan.
Oh.
No, Roshan.
They got that.
Yeah, they got that. Don't worry about any of that. That doesn't concern you. One thing concerns you, and that is getting money. And you go for Roshan now.
Sneak it out.
I'm hoping they don't have vision there. They might, but... Oh, you don't need to go back. Like, the courier is faster than you. Okay, Roshan. No double damage. That would have been neat. So, activate the Mask of Madness. Just stop punching it. If you take a little bit of damage, right, you're gonna. Then, just activate the healing ward. But as you can see, this is just easy. Like, he's already halfway done, and this is kind of how it's gonna go. Like, this is not even a close fight. That's a pretty early Roshan kill. You want to of course drop the shield for the Aegis. And I just kind of keep farming, honestly. Well, you want to... Nah, it's okay. look at Teemo coming in, being a douchebag. Stealing the experience. Kill the Ancients. There's a camp right there. Always keep that going. If there are creeps around, you kill the creeps. You kill the creeps. Don't concern yourself with fight. Those don't matter yet. Now you go mid. That's actually a good opportunity now. You see, everybody has used their abilities. You run in and clean up. If you can get something like this, hell yeah, we take that. Queen of Pain might not be optimal, but you can still get that. You need... A-move? Yeah, sweet. Okay, you can... Probably should go back in. Yeah, no. Get out. Oh, actually... Maybe... Yeah, you can get that guy, but...
No.
Yeah, this is difficult, right? We didn't have any vision on him, but that's fine. Urshaker went down, you had the edges. It's not too big of a deal.
I don't think they realized it.
Yeah, of course not. Like, they were busy fighting while you killed Roshan. And, you know, it's kind of early, and they... It's weird, like, who solo kills Roshan this early, but that's what Juggernaut does. Honestly, you don't even need the Yasha. I just think the Yasha makes it much easier. So, you know. You don't want to max Blade Fury. You don't max anything now, you just get stats.
I just panicked.
Yeah, but just keep getting stats. They are better. Blade Fury is a worthless ability. Like, the only reason why we even have a point into it is for the early game. And because we like having magic immunity. You don't fight. Keep farming. This is the thing about carries, right? It's difficult, but sometimes you just have to say, fuck you, team, right? You're fighting. I don't want to fight. This is a bad fight for me to take. I might die. This is not worth it. And then you just have to leave them to die. Like, that's a big part of playing a carry. Like, discipline. You just need to know when to not fight. And right there, that just wasn't a good fight for your team. So you're gonna let them die. Okay, back to the top lane. Alright, you're gonna go to the top lane. You're gonna start pushing down the tower.
Maiden.
Oh, that is awful. They keep getting picked off. Get yourself a TP. Sell the shield again. Sell it. Well, this time sell it, but you didn't sell it earlier. Get yourself another TP. Always want to have a TP at the ready, right? So, I like carrying two, because then if I use one, I still have one. But, yeah, you know, whatever. You definitely want to always have one, though. So, now as you might have noticed, it's 90 minutes into the game, and look at your items. No, don't go back! Don't go back, they're all top, what can they do? Which hero right now can challenge you pushing the bottom? Right, they're all top. And if somebody on their own comes around, what do we do to that guy? We kill it. Look at your items, Frey. 20 minutes in, what do you have? That's a scary hero. That's a scary Juggernaut. You're looking good, man. You're looking healthy. You're looking powerful. So you said, oh, somebody's coming in. That's Abaddon. You want to leave. Definitely want to leave. Use your face boots, man. You're faster than him. Don't worry about it. Actually, maybe you might not be faster than him. Oh my god, that's stupid. Orb of Venom. Okay, you're fine. Oh, double damage. Mask of Madness. Ah, you need to activate the Mask of Madness by that guy. Can you attack him? No, you can't. Oh, this is a little silly now. Sweet. That was well done. Chase him down. That's an easy kill. Oh, Queen of Pain. Punch her. No! That doesn't do anything. Punch her. Just punch. Ah, crit! Yes! Okay. Frey.
Oh, he gets poisoned. Damn it.
Frey. Blade Fury is awful. We don't use Blade Fury. Okay? If the Queen of Pain already nuked you with all of her abilities, except for the ultimate, right? She used her Scream of Pain on you. She used her Q on you. The Blade Fury, I guess it dispelled the Q, but that's not that important because that got a very low cooldown, right? The Blade Fury did nothing. It all it did was make it so that she couldn't attack her, which is significantly more damage. Also, we're not getting Aghanim's.
Okay.
Aghanim's, I don't like it because it's, you know, it's a little weird, right? Like, how many slashes do you usually get if you use Juggernaut Ultimate? Do you get the full 9? I don't get the full 9 that often. Like, the full 9 happens so rarely that it's just like, why even bother? So they have like two options, I think, here. I would either go for BKB or for an Abyssal Blade. I think the Basher is fine, honestly. But, you know, it kind of depends on what you want to do. Yeah. Somebody's cooking. So, go back to farming. No, don't worry about that. Your team, again, they chose to fight a dumb fight. That is not your problem. That is none of your concern. What you worry about is getting money. Carries are egocentric. There's one thing that worries them, like that they worry about, and that is themselves. You need to get some money. And it's only 22 minutes into the game, man. It's not that late yet. Now, there is an Abaddon up top, which is looking like a pretty tasty proposition, but I don't know if you can do that. The ultimate makes it really difficult. So, it's always a shame to having to drop the Quenning Blade, because it's so fucking good, but I think it's worth it for the Basher. Definitely think so. Now, you're fast, man. Right, you can use the Mask of Madness to move around, you can use the face boots to move around. Honestly, like, if there's a lane to farm it. Right, if there are creeps at the bottom, you go to the bottom and farm there. If there are creeps at the top, you go to the top and farm there. There's really no place on the map that's safe from you. That's really how you gotta play it. You're fast, you're efficient. You try to make use of that.
Don't run alone.
And Crystal Maiden died again. Your supports really need to get their shit together.
Well, it is Crystal Maiden.
Well, this doesn't excuse it, though, right? Like, the issue is not the hero, but the player. Oh, look what I found. It's a present. Oh, you see how much damage you deal? You can't just punch him. Who cares about the healing? You can kill him from full, no problem. You don't need to worry about things like that. Don't be so afraid, man.
I'd rather not.
You are, Frey, you are the most powerful hero on the map right now. Nobody can fight you. Nobody. Not on their own. They will all die without exception. You can kill two of the heroes on your own. Maybe three. You should get that Basher, though. Drop the Quenning Blade and get a Basher. I mean, it's 40 damage, it's pretty good, and it's also on heroes, and it's bash, and it gives you a little bit of HP, and it's definitely better than a Quelling Blade. Not for farming, but generally speaking. But there's nobody on the map that can challenge you.
Right, no, we need to.
So...
I'm just gonna sell it in the side shop here.
Yeah, that's fair. But use the courier to get it already.
Oh no, damn it.
You need to have a hotkey on the courier, honestly. Don't use that stupid button down there. Like, I have the... Okay, so I have my hero hotkey to 3. I've got my courier hotkey to 2. So all I do, if I want to get my item from the courier, is I press 2F, and then I go back to 3. takes like a split second. You need a TP.
I have the, my items set.
TP. To the TP, 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 TP. TPs are more important than fast movement. Okay. Now you, I guess you just use the TP, but oh well. So, important thing you need to do. If your ultimate is going on, you want to activate your your Mask of Madness, right? It doesn't matter if you activate it before, you can activate it while the ultimate is going on. You can use items. Oh, look at that! Fight it! No, why are you afraid? Kill it!
Silenced.
Doesn't matter, hit it! You're Juggernaut. Just punch it in the face. Okay, you don't want to punch like that. This is a pretty bad idea. Okay, ultimate, 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 ultimate.
Can you revive back?
Yes. Ultimate the queen. And just punch. Mask of Madness, Mask of Madness, puncher, Mask of Madness, puncher. Ah! Mask of Madness, puncher! Dude! Oh, you're not gonna get anything now.
That could have been an awesome RP, but she silenced me.
Okay, Blade Fury, you can't do it. Ah, oh, you're dead. You need to do what I tell you to do, man.
But so much stuff going on, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's why it's difficult, though. That's why I'm telling you what to do. So you don't have to think about it. You just listen to what I tell you. Like, the Queen of Pain, what she made a huge mistake right there. She was here, right? And then she blinked here. Which is 6 seconds of time that you can use to punch her. She doesn't live 6 seconds of your attacks. Nobody lives through 6 seconds of your attacks. That just doesn't happen.
Also, I have zero money.
Yeah, because you bought back.
Died.
Then you died again. And now you're not going to get anything while the buyback money negation is going on. But now you're going. Now you're getting something again. Roshan might be back up. That's something worth checking out. You killed him at 16 minutes. But you need to listen to me during those fights. Like, I know it's difficult. But if I say hit the Queen of Pain, then just hit the Queen of Pain. Because the time it takes you to question it is more time than you have to, you know, than you have in a fight. It's just... like, fights are really quick. Dota's a slow-paced game, except if it comes to the fights. During those fights, there's just shit going on all over the place, and you need to keep up with it.
Oh.
And that is nasty. Okay. Yeah, this is gonna be rough. It's definitely gonna be rough. No, you're still really farmed, right? You still have a lot of money. You don't want to challenge top at all. It's two. It's 3 versus 5. You don't fight 3 versus 5. Your top tower's getting all banged up. Let's go ahead and get Roshan. Too bad. You know, he might be up. Invisibility. Oh, you said visibility. You said visibility. Walk over here, and now walk back. I love doing that.
Because you're pushing.
I'm not sure if it's useful in any way, but I love doing it. Okay. I think you need to TP that.
Go TP?
Yeah, TP.
Oh, he missed up.
Oh, that's pretty good. Oh, use the ultimate, just use it. That's pretty good. You got 2 kills. You're gonna get a 3rd. Sweet. Yeah, that's really solid.
Get back to Roshan, I will.
Yeah, definitely. Back to Roshan. He's already halfway dead, and the entire team is halfway dead.
Okay, we can go finish Roshan.
Which, that sentence didn't make any sense, but whatever.
This is not.
Just keep it going, man. Just keep it going. That is very important, right? You never slow down. You never stop farming. Like, as a carry, the moment you stop farming is the moment you lose the game. You always keep it going. Get that, Roshan. Activate that Mask of Madness, and once you get an Abyssal Blade, you're looking really solid. Like, then that Queen of Pain can't fight you anymore. Like, you're gonna overwhelm her so quickly, you just run in.
Yeah, stun, and stop.
Stun her with the Abyssal Blade. Activate the Mask of Madness, and down she goes. She's gonna fall so quickly. It's not gonna be pretty. No, don't steal his farm, get away.
Want the buff?
No! No, don't worry about that. Just go somewhere else, man. Like, that's teamfight shit, right? That's something that doesn't matter while farming.
Free battle tier, basically.
Nah, that's not that important. Jungle top lane, right? get that lane really quick, and I move into the jungle again. Always be on your toes. Always be on your toes. Always keep moving. And make sure you get all of these last hits, right? You missed one right there. You missed two in that creep wave. You always want to keep getting last hits. You always need to pay attention to that. Because every tiny bit of money counts. It really does. Like, all you need right now for your Abyssal Blade is four more last hits. Now it's two more. So, you know. Like, if you had gotten those two, you could have it by now. So you always want to keep that going. And there you go. Send the courier over there, get that Abyssal Blade. And yeah, now you start pushing, I think. It's 30 minutes into the game, you're basically 6 slotted. No, the courier! Oh my god. The courier almost died, holy shit. That would be pretty bad. Use the courier, use the courier. Get, oh, what's going on? Yellow, that's Queen of Pain. Always pay attention to the minimap too, right? Queen of Pain got Ioscard, it doesn't really matter that much. Hey, you might be able to catch her now. Okay. Oh, that's actually good. Dasher. Stunner? Yeah, keep that going. Ah, the Shackle didn't latch. Nice! Omni Slash. Got one. Punch the Queen of Pain. Punch the Queen of Pain. Mask of Madness, punch her. Mask of Madness. Ah, that's okay. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. Your team needs to help you. Your team isn't. That's
unfortunate. The fuck?
Well, yeah. You know, I don't know what that was about. Bane is gonna drop right here.
She's got a Scotty.
Yeah, she's pretty beefy. Pretty tanky. Ah, that fight didn't go too well. That's pretty awful, I guess.
Oh shit, I have 233 last hits.
Hell yeah. Hate to be your mid tower, right? I mean, that's how you farm. I mean, that was the point of this. Even if you don't win this game. I mean, you
learning
tried.
Experience.
And you got a lot of money, didn't you?
Yeah.
And that's really the key to these heroes, right? It's that constant movement. It's being around the map, like basically at all places at the same time. And in fights, you just burst down everything. At least that's the plan. Now, it's difficult against their team because Abaddon... I think Abaddon is actually really nice against Juggernaut because he can't just tank Omni Slash hits. Which makes it tricky. But that's okay, right? Oh, Shackle. Oh, that one hit.
Well, she's dead.
Yeah.
She's definitely dead. Oh, yeah.
That was a good Shackle. I'm still a little surprised that the one in the fight, like in the big fight, didn't connect. No, this game isn't over at all, right? Oh, chase him down. Chase him down. You can totally get that. You're so fast. You're moving at max.
Oh,
no!
Ah, fuck you, mate. I'm gonna get you with this.
Okay, I guess that works. I guess that
I misclicked.
Works. No, it's okay. It's okay.
Oh, I can't skill stats anymore.
Well, get the healing ward then. Well, this is by no means over, right? You're looking pretty good. Oh! Nah, not quite. If you find somebody like that, just use your ultimate, right? Like, that's perfectly okay. I mean, it's a free kill. I don't believe that an ultimate needs to give you more than one kill. Like, some people think that certain ultimates need to, like, win an entire team fight or something like that.
Yeah, I don't expect Omnislash to give me more than one kill.
Yeah, like, use it. And honestly, one kill is fine. If every ultimate on your team gets you one kill, then you won the fight. You don't need more than that.
Five heroes.
So, keep using the Mask of Madness. You see how much damage you deal with that? Like, that's what makes it so powerful. And again, you need to be aware of when you use it. Like, you need to make sure you use it when your Omni Slash is going on, because it buffs it up so, so much. It increases the DPS of the Omni Slash by a tremendous amount.
Wait.
That's a lot of Blink Daggers, man.
For a second, I thought there was two Arch Shakers blinking around.
Kind of the same hero, anyway. Oh, Fiend's Grip. He's gonna have an ultimate, though. Okay, stun him.
Good.
Don't punch. I guess that's okay. It doesn't really matter. Sweet. So, right here, I would personally probably get a BKB. You know, It's rather apparent that you need one, I think. It's while it's an unfortunate item to get, right, it's always like, BKB. But you're gonna need it here. They have so much magic going on. And the biggest problem is, like, I think you can tell, but during those fights you keep getting stunned, so you want to do something against that. Oh, mate, yeah, you need to go help. You need to go help. Drop an ultimate. Just drop an ultimate on that Queen of Pain. Oh, big. Come on. Oh, there we go. Beautiful. Triple Ultra Team Wipe. Fantastic. That's a full BKB done. That's what you need.
Yeah.
Well, if you get some more of those.
Well, I got the thing as well in power.
Yeah. That was amazing. Beautiful fight. So the Ring of Aquila is not really that important at this point, honestly.
I set up whenever.
Yeah, I personally prefer keeping TPs. I think TPs are always important. Especially if your base is exposed, right? And you want to avoid any backdoors or anything like that. Also, you can totally just heal up. Yeah, use the healing ward and keep pushing. You can get a lot down here. You see how much damage you deal? That is two attacks. That's two. Oh. You're gonna get a few more. Boom. Dead. That's Juggernaut. Mask of Madness, man. Keep using that. At all times, right? Keep it going. Urshaker is back. I think you No. You can totally get this. Oh, maybe not. Ah, I'm sorry.
Ah!
That was my miscall.
That was what I was afraid of.
Yeah, no. That was my miscall.
Expect the Echo Slam.
I really thought you could get that. I'm kind of hoping. That's okay. It's not that important. I really wanted that barracks.
Yeah, me too. We really wanted that barracks.
Really wanted that barracks, but didn't quite make it. Oh, well.
I should have saved the queue.
Yeah, definitely. Like, that was a little early, and it's mostly like there was nobody around that could really do anything, but it's not that big of a deal, right? Like, I should have just told you to retreat, but I really wanted that barracks. Like, look, the thing is, I would have died right there too, because I really wanted that barracks. So I think next in line is probably a butterfly. Honestly, at this point, it's a little difficult to make the call, but I personally like butterfly a lot. I think it's a nice mixture of offense and defense. And, you know, you have BKB now, so you should be able to, you know.
So I shouldn't go for Aghanim's.
No, Aghanim's just isn't that great. Like, the thing about Aghanim's is, right, like, it buffs up your ultimate in not the kind of way you want it, right? Juggernaut is a burst hero. You can feel this, right? Like, how do the fights go for you? How would you describe one of your fights?
Quick.
That's a little short, but I guess so, alright? You go in, you punch people like 3-4 times, and then they are dead. And then you move on to the next target. You just move fast, you move quickly, and you try to get fights over in a few seconds.
Crits?
I can check.
You already got crits.
Oh yeah, never mind. But doesn't it stack?
I don't know if those two stack. I think they do, but diminishingly, and it's not that great.
Divine
Rapier. That's something for later. I think getting a butterfly will be fine. Now keep farming, though. There's still a jungle.
Getting a bit cocky now.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, it's likely risky, but you do have a BKB, right? So I don't think you need to be that afraid. Only has a 40-second cooldown, but that's still a 40-second window. Maybe you can catch her. I guess not. Oh! That's unfortunate. Yeah, I'm not getting that. Oh! Ultimate! The Queen of Pain! No! You're not getting the Queen of Pain! Oh, big! Come on, just punch her. You need to stun the Queen of Pain. Oh, that's Abaddon. Oh, that's the wrong hero. Punch the Queen of Pain. That's unfortunate.
Oh, I think that...
No. You still got a bunch of kills right there. I don't know if you...
Yeah, but there's so many people, I didn't know where the Queen of Pain was.
Yeah, it's difficult, but yeah, you need to spot out the right target.
Ooh.
No. Yeah, I guess you can. No.
Oh, something's dead.
No, just leave it. Abaddon, I hate that item build. The saddest thing about that Abaddon item build is like how many people believe that it's actually any good. It's just horrible. Oh well.
Like his helmet though. Like a footman.
Yeah, it does actually look pretty neat.
Oh no! Wind Ranger, you're dead.
Not quite.
Not dead. You're dead though.
That's not gonna do it, but
that's dead though.
Yeah. Okay.
Ice killed ice.
You also should use your W during those fights, right? You get a lot of healing out of that. It's actually really valuable. It's a huge ability.
We'll be back for the refresh.
So, I want to do that. And it's a little less important because you're going up against AA, right? Which makes it so that I'm probably not even going to get any healing, but I still think that it's worthwhile.
Roach, maybe? Is he?
Okay. I don't know if he's up. Did anybody check if he's up? Oh,
yeah,
if,
yeah, he
is. Is he?
Oh, there's a fight.
There's a dead.
You want to go in? Oh, no. You need to be careful with the Mask of Madness before fights. Okay. Oh, that's fine. Got him. That's pretty good. Yeah, go kill Roshan.
That's done too.
Yup. This is pretty good. This is actually really, really good. And power, that's also gonna be a cheese. Activate that Mask of Madness again. And God. Like, this is the scary thing about Juggernaut, right? Like, he's strong early, and now it's late game, and he's still strong. Like, this hero's just good at all stages. It's stupid. It's just ridiculous.
Oh, can't... guess I'm maxing that now.
Now you're maxing Blade Fury.
So what do I sell?
Nothing.
Well, after the Aegis run, I don't probably...
You get the butterfly after the Aegis runs out, but... For the time being, you just keep everything. Keep saving money. So I don't really know where your team went, if I'm completely honest.
I think they just...
Yo, why did you go all the way back?
I got homesick.
Yeah. The fuck? Seems like
get
it.
Get back here! No, I can't talk.
So can we go mid all of you?
All of you went back, you know? Your bottom tower. Yeah, I know that Queen of Pain was pushing, but whatever. Bash? Oh, no, not quite. Oh, no, Frey. That Mask of Madness is really important. You need to be careful with that. Like, early on you can use it for farming, that's fine. But right now you need it for the fights. And if it's on cooldown during a fight, that's pretty important. Oh, you can actually punch him. Oh, Urshaka BKB, you need to BKB right away. Okay, that's fine. You're gonna die, you're gonna resurrect. You got BKB. Activate the BKB right away. Okay, punch. Mask of Madness.
Just finish.
Oh, sweet.
Let's take everything we go for base now.
Queen of Pain. Oh,
this is a cheeky bastard. What, top.
No. Go mid.
She finished?
Finished again. You can totally just finish it. She won't finish faster than you.
No, why are you back? Oh, okay.
Just go finish. It's a buyback from the Abaddon.
No, don't.
Just go finish. You're not gonna... I don't know. Yeah, this is a little... silly.
Try finish.
Okay, you're dead. You need to get out. Okay, Frey, finishing is not attacking the barracks, and you need to go for, like, the towers.
You have buyback?
No, there's no buyback. That's also why I wanted you to save money, by the way, so you have buyback ready. Did you just sell something? Frey, talk to me.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm not thinking straight now.
It's okay, you lost the barracks, but you got a barracks as well, so I guess it kind of evens out. It could be worse.
Although that shouldn't be there.
It was on the... How did you even sell something?
I don't know. That shouldn't be possible.
Yeah, no, that's why I'm a little confused as well. You can't actually sell by dead. That doesn't make a lot of sense now. Hmm. Okay, so now this is actually where Juggernaut kind of reaches the end of what he can do. Like, while this hero is very powerful, he's more of a mid-game carry, honestly. Like, he's not super amazing in the late game. Like, at 45 minutes, you want the game to be over. And the fact that it isn't, like, now you're still getting stronger, right? But I think there are a lot of other heroes that at this point get stronger at a more exponential rate than a Juggernaut does. Which is gonna make it difficult. I think at this point, we might want to start thinking... Like, first of all, finish up the Butterfly, right? But after the Butterfly, might want to start thinking about maybe selling the Mask of Madness and picking up, like, proper lifesteal or maybe a Scali or something like that. But...
No, I don't have TP, damn it.
No, get the Eagle Song. Get the Eagle Song.
Okay, let's go...
Oh my god.
He's got a Mjolnir.
Yeah, I know. That Abaddon is being ridiculous. Now, that build is stupid, but I guess if the game lasts 46 minutes, then it's gonna be useful.
Oh!
Because it's just kind of like, let's build a carry on a hero that is not a carry. Alright. After 46 minutes, my carry items start being useful. Surprise! Oh, kill the Queen of Pain. Running. Getting murdered.
Oh shit! I just
killed you. Well, you got something, and you had the Mask of Madness active. Did you see the difference? There's such a massive difference just for having that item active.
I know there's someone left.
Yeah, there's AA and there's a Queen of Pain.
Abaddon doesn't have buyback. We can just go finish.
There's a guy. Hello.
Oh, punch it.
He creeps.
Totally earned.
Try go mid.
Just. Yeah.
Okay. I don't think you can finish here. Like, the resurrections are gonna be there too quickly. I would just go push top or something.
Get some more money. Butterfly.
You don't always have to walk back to get your items. I know. It's a little weird, honestly. Like, you always walk towards the courier.
I guess.
Emo, that's not happening.
Why not?
Because resurrections. Earthshaker's gonna be back, Sand King's gonna be
back. Should I go for.
Just look at the creeps.
Boots of Travel?
I guess. Honestly, at this point, you definitely want to go for buyback.
Yeah, buyback.
I think that's something you want to have available.
Oh my god.
It doesn't matter that they don't have alts. It's still gonna be a 3-on-3. You can't just finish the game 3-on-3. Also, we don't have ultimates either. Like, that argument is mute. And Queen of Pain actually does have an ultimate, because that ultimate got 40 seconds cooldown. Ah, these people.
Rabbit.
They know so little. They know so little. Yeah, Earthshaker and Sand King are not gonna have one, but so Juggernaut and Magnus also didn't have one. So, there's that. Okay.
So now I can move around even more. The flutter.
Yeah, it actually gives you more movement. That's pretty cool. I always forget to use that. If I play a hero with Butterfly, I always forget to activate that ability. Because, like, for 7 years it did not have it active. And now it suddenly has. And I'm just like, no. Why would you do this?
Okay. So how much do I... How much buyback? 800 more.
Yeah. 800 more. You need... A team kind of should stick together, honestly. Like, you need to just make a decision.
What
you
time was the last rush?
I think around 44 or something.
43 about that.
I wish we had clockwork now.
Yeah, he would be very useful in this situation.
Well, you need some vision. We can push a lot of vision.
So, it's gonna be difficult, like, right here. Honestly, the most powerful hero on their team is probably the Queen of Pain, right? So if you can target her down, that's gonna be really useful, but... At the same time, there's also Earthshaker and go. Oh, that's pretty good. That's a free kill. No, go in! Why are you running back? Go in! BKB! BKB punch things! BKB punch things! Oh yes! Punch the Queen of Pain! Abyssal Blade? No, you need to use the Abyssal Blade, man. Okay, it's fine. You're gonna have to buy back, I think.
I do have the buyback now.
Yeah, but you need to activate your Abyssal Blade. If you had used the Abyssal Blade on the Queen of Pain, you could have gotten that kill.
I don't think I have good buttons.
What do you have button? Like, what kind of buttons?
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, space, and alt, 4.
Okay. That's a little weird, but I guess so. Whatever works for you, but...
I don't think...
I think you have to buy back. Just buy back here. And you don't want to destroy your base entirely. Run in, Abyssal Blade. You might be able to get that kill. Run in, Abyssal Blade. You might be able to get that kill. Oh. Oh, F-Hero. Well, that's fun. You should be fine, honestly. Maybe you're not. Oh, Mask of Madness, come on! Oh, you got her! Sweet! Heal! Oh, Frej! You need to use your abilities and items! You've got all the tools, but you're not using them. You got all of the tools in your toolbox, but you keep dropping the toolbox.
I think it might have to do something to do with your voice. It's too soothing. I don't know.
Oh, Frej.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. We had a good run.
Who the fuck is watching my game?
The thing about the late game is that you can't really... I can't really tell you exactly what to do because a lot of it is very reactionary. You just need to see and then react to what's going on. But you know what? You had the second highest GPM in the game. You had 670 gold per minute, which is really solid. Your farm was great. You were 6 slotted. I think we did pretty well right here. Didn't win, but you know, like, that's gonna come with time. So yeah, that's basically Juggernaut. And I think next time we're gonna do Troll.
Troll
Lord. That is if there is a next time. I don't know if people actually want to see more of it.
I don't know. We shall see.
I don't know, but I'm probably gonna tell you about Troll anyway. But yeah, so that this is kind of Coach Arino or something like that.
Coach Arino.
Almost win Arino. Almost won. Pretty close though. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video and shit like that. Leave a rating or shit. I don't care.
Down below.
Yes. No, you can also leave it up below. I don't really care where you leave it. Like, wherever the button is, that button is okay with me. Anyway, so that's that.